Hi there. Today I'm going to explain little bit about path tool. This one in GIMP 2.8, as it's a very important tool for drawing in GIMP. Now when we click on the tool, its edit mode opens under tool options, under which we can find these three usage options. Design. In this option, you can use the path tool to design or create any shape you like. Edit. Hotkey control. In this option, you can connect nodes and change shapes of the already designed shape with the path tool. Move. Hotkey Alt. You can move the shape that you have created with this option. Now let's try the tool. Select the tool, then click on the canvas. You see there's a round shape with a square shape on top of it. Each round shape that the path tool creates is called node. The square shape appears when a particular node is selected. Here, the first node we created is selected. Now click on one side. The first node became only a round shape, as it's not selected anymore, and the square shape appeared on the second node that I have created. Now click on another position to make a third node. Now I want to connect the third node with the first one to create a shape. Let's see what happens when I click on the first node again to connect while the design option is selected. Only the first node gets the square shape appeared on it, that is, the node itself is selected but both the nodes do not join. So, to join two nodes, what we do is select edit option or press Ctrl key from the keyboard under Windows and then click on the first node again. Now we got a closed shape. Now here is an option called selection from path, which turns the shape that we create with path tool into a selection. And stroke path option lets you stroke or make a border of the selection. I click on the selection from path option. The area of the shape gets selected. See the dotted line along the path? That implies that the area is selected. Now we can fill the area inside the selection with fill bucket tool. Deselect the area from select, then none. Now let's see how we can draw a smooth curvy shape with this tool. Select the tool, keep the edit mode in design option. Click at a point on the canvas, then click on a desired distance. Now, without lifting or detaching your pressure on your tablet or mouse left button, drag the selection you just created. Lift it when you are happy with the curve and click again to make a new node little further. And so on. Attach the nodes under edit option and a figure with smooth curve is created. Now click on stroke path and the pop-up opens. I am keeping solid collection which will give solid border. There's pattern option which will give pattern border. Line width determines the thickness of the border and you can choose any other tool to stroke with from the option. Stroke with a paint tool and by selecting the tool from the drop-down. If we select this option, the drop-down becomes enabled. And these are the possible options we can use to stroke. If you are using graphic tablet, turning on emulate brush dynamics will make your stroke look like a brush stroke with pressure points, like drawn with a tablet. For now, I am keeping solid color and then click on stroke. The shape that I made is now stroked with the foreground color and it looks like a bee. Now I create some random shape and then select the move option under path edit mode. You see, now you can move the shape anywhere. Now if you say you don't want any curvy lines, you wanna make a shape all made of straight lines, Then, while designing the shape, check on polygonal option. Now see, you cannot create any smooth curve with it, only straight lines. And I made a box. Now right click on it, edit, and you can use these option. Fill with FG color, fill with BG color, fill with pattern, or even stroke path. Now let's draw something. Select the path tool, change the foreground color. Now click on the middle of the canvas. Click on slightly above and without detaching the pressure, make a little curve and then click directly below the first node. Now add first and third node by pressing Ctrl from the keyboard or selecting edit option. Now click on selection from path. The shape got selected. So now fill the shape with foreground color. Deselect the shape. Right click on the shape layer and duplicate the layer. Select flip tool and click on the duplicated shape layer. Now take the move tool and reposition the shape in a way that it looks like a heart. Now right click on the top layer and select merge down. You got a perfect shaped heart using path tool. Now let's see how edit option works for this tool. I change the foreground color. Now using the path tool, I create a loop shape. Right click on it, go to edit and fill with FG color. Or fill with BG color. Or fill with pattern. Also, you can use the stroke path option, which is another way of stroking the shape, with solid color or with pattern. There are various uses of this tool which made this tool very important. Hope I could share some valuable information about this tool with you. Check out other tutorials I have made. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel for more. Thanks and have a great day.